Welcome to another episode of Back to Basics. I'm Aaron Lima, and today we're going to discuss some recommended ways to configure EC2 instances after deployment. In order to be useful, a screwdriver needs a screw. The same can be said of an EC2 instance. It needs an application to be installed to be truly useful. Maybe you need to install a COTS-based application, which is a consumer off-the-shelf application, to your EC2 instance. Or you need to install and configure software such as Nginx or IIS. Now, you can do all these tasks manually, but in the cloud, you want to get away from manual tasks as much as possible and have a fully automated deployment. How do you perform a fully automated deployment in AWS? Well, by using tools such as AWS CloudFormation, you can not only ensure repeatable deployments, but you can also have a way to document and track changes over time. While CloudFormation excels at deploying AWS resources and can perform configuration management, it is recommended to use a tool purpose-built for the job, which is AWS Systems Manager. And in this episode, we're going to discuss how to use AWS CloudFormation to deploy an EC2 instance and then use AWS Systems Manager to perform configuration management on that instance. We'll also walk through some patterns of using auto-scaling groups and AWS Systems Manager together to perform configuration management. Let's go ahead and dive in. To define infrastructure with AWS CloudFormation, you create a template either written in JSON or YAML. You could also use the AWS Cloud Development Kit, which will generate a template for you. This allows you to use an imperative programming language you are comfortable with, like TypeScript, Python, Go, and others. However, when the template is submitted to the CloudFormation service, it creates a stack. A stack is a unit of related AWS resources. If that stack includes an EC2 instance, you most likely need to install software or configure settings. If this is the case, within the stack, you can also create an AWS Systems Manager State Manager Association. When you create a State Manager Association, you select a document, and SSM has many documents that can apply things such as Ansible playbooks or run PowerShell scripts or Bash scripts. Once an EC2 instance with an SSM agent boots up and checks in with the SSM service, it first asks if there are any State Manager Associations to apply. This makes for a good mechanism to perform bootstrap actions. Anything you might perform with EC2 user data, you can use SSM for, provided the instance includes the SSM agent. When creating the State Manager Association, you can set it to have CloudFormation to wait until the configuration completes successfully. In doing so, when the stack is created successfully, you'll know that your instances have been configured as well. Now, a benefit of this pattern is being able to push logs centrally for troubleshooting purposes. The SSM agent can handle pushing the standard output of our config task to an Amazon S3 bucket. So if your configuration fails, you don't need to SSH or RDP to the instances to collect logs, or add additional lines of code to push logs somewhere. The agent will handle that for you. Now, just a word on your scripts. To take advantage of State Manager, you should have idempotent scripts, meaning that they can be rerun and check configuration and only act when configuration has drifted. This is where config tools like PowerShell, DSC, Ansible, Chef, or Puppet would come, and SSM has documents that support all of these tools. Now, our first pattern, we talked through using SSM to configure an EC2 instance deployed by CloudFormation. But let's say our stack creates an auto-scaling group. Well, State Manager allows us to target instances specifically or by tags or resource groups. Remember that when the SSM agent registers itself to the service, it asks if there are any State Manager Associations to apply. So, if we create our State Manager Association to target based on a tag, we can also configure an EC2 instance that is deployed in an auto-scaling group, and it will be configured as it boots up. Traffic will be sent to the EC2 instance once it reports as healthy to the auto-scaling group. In this episode, we explored how we can configure EC2 instances deployed by AWS CloudFormation or auto-scaling groups with a State Manager Association. We also highlighted the importance of using idempotent scripts and tools and methods when using this pattern. This pattern can be used when installing web servers or consumer off-the-shelf applications. Please check out the links below for more details. See you next time.